Hey guys, welcome to another episode of the Mat Pack. Guys, I'm sorry it took a while to get another video up, but we're trying to get things restarted through this COVID thing, trying to work things out, really busy right now. Guys, so today is gonna be tipper talk, okay? Guys, people wanna know what kind of dog he is, how big he's gonna get, what's his temperament, do I recommend a Great Dane to a first-time dog owner? So let's go over some of these questions. First, the type of dog is a Great Dane, okay? He's a European Great Dane, okay? There's a difference between European and American. Europeans tend to be a little bit bigger, a little bit more droopier in the jaws, okay? Very active today, guys. He likes to pull on this. That's why I have this not a very good leash because he's chewing today. But very good dog if you're not high maintenance. Meaning, if you can't spend 2.5, 3.5 hours exercising a dog, a Great Dane's for you, my friend. Okay, we go for 2 walks. We go for a walk midday for about half an hour, and we go about an hour at night. Okay, so we do a total about 1.5 hour, 45 minute walks a day, and that's it. Okay, he is tired after that. He sleeps all night. He is 3 months, 3 weeks. Heavy right now too. He's about 55 pounds. So once we walk, he'll sleep all night. Okay, he's not getting up going to the bathroom anymore. He sleeps all night. He gets up in the morning, goes to his washroom, so he's able to hold it as well. Okay. The thing about the walks is it burns that little bit of extra energy he has. I found before when I wasn't quite, when he wasn't quite ready to walk, he'd be very anxious all night. I'd have to get up at 2, I'd have to get up at 4, I'd have to get up at 6 to take him outside. But now, maybe it's because he's bigger too, is that he can last pretty much all night. There's sometimes when he whines and he has to go outside. He's very good and letting me know when he has to go to the washroom too. He has a certain sound he makes. So, when you have a dog, listen, okay? Feel your dog out, get to know your dog. Now, do I recommend Great Danes as a breed? I recommend them highly. Even if you're a first-time dog owner, they're very, very, very good and loyal. They're not high maintenance, so you don't have to worry about them barking and chewing and causing lots of problems. They like to sit by you, they like to relax, they like to be by you, okay? I take him everywhere with me, so I go to the store, he comes, so I socialize him, okay? He's gonna be anywhere from 180 to 200 pounds, okay? If I don't socialize a dog that big, things can go bad, okay? He'll be leery around people. He'll be leery around kids, okay? And I don't want him that. I want him to be a confident dog looking for me for leadership, okay? So he knows I'm here, okay? He knows that I will take care of him and I'll look after his best interest. He knows that, okay? I know he knows that already, okay? Now the diet. Man, diet's been kind of a roller coaster for me. I started off giving him nothing but raw meat, okay? Then I noticed, I don't know if because he was a big breed dog, that he's getting a lot of like joint pains, a lot of groin pain. So I added a little bit of kibble with it. Pain's gone. He doesn't have those random pains anymore. So I think it helps him because he's such a fast growing dog. He needed that extra calories. Okay. So once I did that, pain's gone. But on the other hand, if he goes on a play date with another dog and they play hard, he'll be sore for the next 2 or 3 days, okay? So you gotta expect that with a Great Dane. You gotta watch. You gotta make sure they have these long limbs. You gotta make sure that they don't get damaged or hurt, or excessive playing could hurt them as well, right? His best friend's a Doberman and 2 Frenchies. The Frenchies play nice and calm because they're lower, smaller, but the Doberman bounces off his head, okay? So you gotta watch. You gotta learn what habits your dogs have and what they don't, okay? Be careful. You don't want your friends to get hurt, and that's what they are. They're part of your family, they're your friends, okay? You notice that? didn't chase that guy, sat there, and I socialized him from day one. He's used to being around people. He's around 20 kids a day, all day. Okay, that was a really good opportunity to show you guys. He noticed it. He looked at me. I did nothing. He didn't react. Dog that isn't socialized or don't listen, they would have chased him. They would have chased it as something moving away from him. It looked like prey. Okay? Know your dog, guys. That is the main thing, okay? Just like jiu-jitsu, right? I have to know a move really well. I have to put that same effort into raising a dog. And I never really did that in the past. You know, I had a dog and I play with it. I teach it to fetch. But I never really socialize as much as I do with him, or take him out places, have him around people. Okay, and don't get me wrong, you get a Great Dane dog, guys, people come to you. Okay, people want to say hi, people want to see what kind of dog he is. He's a very unique color as well, so people are confused. They're like, well, what kind of dog is he? So they come up and see him. He's very friendly with kids. I tell kids, you know what, remain standing, bend at the hips, and pet him. Okay. For any big dog owner, man, that's what you should do. If a kid goes to the level, the dog wants to play. He wants to knock the kid over. Okay? So he doesn't have that habit, because from day one, I've always told kids, make sure you stand to pet him. Don't crowd him. Okay? Be verbal as well. If you have a group of kids around your dog and they're doing something wrong, let them know they're doing something wrong. Okay? You do not want your dog accidentally hurting anybody. Okay, so be aware. That's the key. Same as jiu-jitsu. Be aware of your surroundings. Okay, one thing too. Great Danes, they miss you. If you're not around, they'll whine. They'll get sad. They'll want to be around you and people. Okay, so that's a little bit of information today about my Great Dane Tipper. This is experience I've had with him. I mean, other people's experience may not be the same, but I love this dog, man. I love this breed. I also have a Doberman, polar opposite. Doberman's very high strung, high energy dog. I had a lot of work getting up, doing stuff with him. I find the Great Dane suits me better, suits my lifestyle better. I can have him a club when I'm teaching class. He sits there and watches the class. Man, I tell you, once you train a dog and are comfortable with just the basics, I don't care if he can bang, play dead, roll over, that stuff doesn't matter to me. But if he can sit and stay, man, that's the world to me, okay? If he knows how to lay down, if he knows not to jump on people, okay? He's a 200-pound dog, maybe. I can't have him jumping on people, okay? Guys, this is the Mat Pack. We'll see you soon with some moves. Awesome. Guys, this is the Mat Pack. Hit the subscribe, hit that bell. Guys, wear sunscreen, because this will happen to you. Bert, only thing that gives me peace is the water.